Welcome back, students, to another class of International English Olympiad workbook. Okay, so in our today's discussion, we are going to discuss about jumbled words, chapter 12. Okay, now what is the meaning of jumbled word? Jumbling things mean to mix things together in a confused and untidy way. Okay, so what we are supposed to do here, we are supposed to arrange the sentence or the words in their proper manner, like first subject, then the helping verb, then the main verb, then our object, to make it a proper meaningful sentence. Okay, so we are given here few sentence that we have to rearrange the in a proper way to make it a meaningful sentence. Okay, so let us begin. First, we are asked here that rearrange the words to make a meaningful sentence. What we are supposed to do here? We are supposed to do here to rearrange the jumbled words in a proper way. So our words here is, summer is in it wonderful hills to go the. So does it make any sense? No. So we have to arrange the things in a way so that it will become a meaningful sentence. We have to arrange the words in a way so that it makes a meaningful sentence. Now let us see. Summer, to go to hill, is it wonderful time in wonderful the in summer? Does it make any sense? No. It is wonderful to go to the hills in summer. Okay, that quite makes sense. In the summer too. No, it is wonderful in the summer to go to the hills too. Okay, so after reading all the sentences, we can understand that only the option B would be the right answer, because if we arrange the words in proper order, only this sentence makes a proper meaning. So number two, B for question number one, B is the correct option. Let us move to our next word, next set of words. Two is the tribe peace warring there between. Okay, now let us see. Peace is there, the between warring tribes two. There is warring peace tribes two. No, there is peace between the two warring tribes. Okay, that makes sense. So for question number two, our answer would be, there is peace between the two warring tribes. For question number two, our answer is option number C. There is peace between two warring tribes. Now let us move to question number three. Could accident few unhurt from escape the fire? So this is our these are the words. Okay, now what would be the right answer? Let us read from the beginning. Option number A, few could escape unhurt from the fire accident. Okay, bingo. We just find our right answer at the beginning. So few could escape unhurt from the fire accident, that completely makes sense. So our for question number three, our answer should be option number A. Now the question number four. Many, anyone, I, were, there, but, no, not, now, did. Okay, that's a tough one. I did not know anyone, but many, there, were. Okay, for question number four. There were many, I not know anyone, but did. Both of these sentences doesn't make any sense. Many were there, but I did not know anyone. This is our correct answer, because this completely makes sense, that many people were there, but I didn't know anyone. Okay, now let us move to question number five. Economy, the of is Indian farmer backbone. Okay, Pharma, now read from the beginning. Option number A, farmer backbone economy Indian of the is the doesn't make any sense. The Indian backbone of is the farmer economy doesn't make any sense. Okay, let us move to option number C. The farmer is the backbone of Indian economy. Yes, that makes sense. So for question number 5, our answer should be option number C. Now let us move to question number 6. Stood first, team first, who the in class in? Okay. So it will be an interrogative question because we have got a question mark here. Okay. So for question number 6, let us read from the first option. First, who stood in the class in first term? No, that doesn't make any sense. Who stood first in the class in the in first term? Okay, that makes sense. So our right answer should be who stood first in the class in first term. Let us move to question number 7. When arranging the words in proper order for jumbled words or jumbled sentences, what you have to do? You have to be careful about the grammatical errors, about the sense, about the placement of the subject and the object and everything. Be very careful about the placement of the parts of speech. That is the noun, pronoun, subject, verb, adverb, and all of these are in proper order, proper manner, and that must make a sense. Okay, now pen, me, is, gave, you beautiful, the very. Does that make any sense? No. To me, it is just senseless word. Now, for question number 7, let us read from the option D. You gave me pen is very beautiful. No, that doesn't make any sense. The pen is very beautiful you gave me. Does that make any sense? No. You gave me the pen is very beautiful. You gave me the pen. Okay. Kind of you may seem that it is true. Okay, let us see. The first sentence, let us read the first sentence, the first option. The pen you gave me is very beautiful. Okay. More than this, this sentence makes sense. So, this would be the right answer. The pen you gave me is very beautiful. Okay. Now, question number 8. Earth, the Venus is two planet closest. Okay, let us make a meaningful sentence for question number 8. Let us read from the beginning. Earth is closest to the planet Venus. Does that make any sense? Like the placement of the to the. That doesn't make any sense. Okay. The is the closest Earth Venus? No. This also doesn't make any sense. Option number C. Venus is the closest planet to the Earth. Okay, that makes sense. So, for question number 8, correct answer is option number C. Now, question number 9. Helps who? Help God, those themselves only. Okay, for question number 9, let us begin from the option number D. Those who help themselves helps only God. Does that make any sense? No. Help who? Help those themselves? God only. Does that make any sense? No. God only. Option number B. God only helps those who help themselves. Okay. So, for question number 9, our correct answer is God helps those who help themselves. So, for question number 9, our correct answer is option number D.
Now question number 10. Listen what two parents your say. Okay, let us begin from the first. What your parents say, listen to. That doesn't make any sense. Your parents say, listen to what? Does that make any sense? No. Listen to what your parents say. Does that make any sense? Yes. Listen to what your parents say. Okay? Now, question number 11. Horse has the heart itself. Okay, horse has heart itself. Let us start. For question number 11. Horse has heart the itself. Does that make any sense? No. Itself horse has the heart. Completely meaningless. The horse has heart itself. This is our right answer. For question number 11, the right answer is the horse has heart itself. Okay. Now let us move to our next question. Poor man laughed the boys at the. Okay. Let us start from the option number D. Okay. The man at the laughed the poor boys. The man at the laugh, no, this completely doesn't make any sense. The man poor laughed the boys at. The man poor laughed at the boys. No, this also doesn't make any sense. Poor the man laughed at boys. Does that make any sense? No. The boys laughed at the boys is the subject, laughing is the verb, and the poor man, the position and the object. So it completely makes sense. So for question number 12, the correct answer is option A. Now let us move to our next set of words. What are those? Anything, nor, neither, he is, no, friends, he. Okay. Question number 13. Neither nor he, his friends, anything, no. Does that make any sense? Let us see. Neither he nor his friends know anything. Nor he, his friend, neither know anything. He, his friends, nor know nothing neither. Anything neither. All of these sentences are meaningless. Only sentence neither he nor his friends know anything makes sense. So this is our correct answer for question number 13. Let us move to question number 14. Has hung wall on the who painting the question mark. So it would be a interrogative sentence because we have a question mark. Okay, for question number 15. Hung who painting has on the wall. So one of the most important feature of an interrogative question that it should start with be verb like is, was, where, or WH, a WH questions. Okay. So does that make any sense? Who painting has on the wall? No, completely meaningless. Has who hung the painting on the wall? No. Who has hung the painting on the wall? It makes complete sense. Who has hung the painting on the wall? Okay. So for question number 14, our right answer is option number C. Now question number 15. Don't have I money enough?
Don't have I money enough.
Enough money, don't have I. I don't have enough money.
I don't enough money. Don't have enough money I.
Okay. So what makes sense?
Don't have enough money I.
No, that is a wrong composition.
I don't have enough money.
Okay. I
have don't enough money.
Wrong.
I don't have enough money.
Option number B.
I don't have enough money.
So our option number B is the right answer for question number 15. Now let us move to question number 16.
Foothills we on the of life Himalayas.
Okay. Himalayas we live on the of the foothills. Option number A. Option number B.
We live on the foothill of the Himalayas.
We live off the foothills on the Himalayas.
We foothills on the Himalayas the live.
Okay. This doesn't make any sense. We live off the foothills on the Himalayas.
No.
We live on the foothills of Himalayas.
Okay.
So for question number 16, option B is the correct answer. For question number 16, option B is the correct answer. Now question number 17.
Waited to for back turn they impatiently there.
Waited to for back turn they impatiently there.
They wait impatiently for their turn to bat.
Impatiently they bat for their waited turn to.
Too bad for their waited, they impatiently turn.
They waited impatiently to their bat for turn.
Okay.
What would be the correct answer then? So we have to arrange according to the rules of grammar, keeping in mind, and the sentence would make a proper sense. So this sentence doesn't make any sense. The bat, too bad for their wicket, they doesn't make any sense. Impatiently they wait the bat for their wicket turn too. Doesn't make any sense. They waited impatiently for their turn to bat. Okay, this sentence completely makes sense and it is according to the rules of grammar. So for question number 17, our correct answer is option number A. Now let us move to question number 18.
Need I, you eat, you help, when will?
Okay.
When I need you, it will help.
Does that make any sense?
No. I will help you when you need it.
Okay. So here our correct answer is option number B. I will help you when you need it. Now let us move to question number 19.
With Faz, all his friends' clothes they are donated.
Okay. Now question number 19. Let us read the option. Option number A.
With his Faz friends, all their clothes donated.
Doesn't make any sense.
Their clothes, old friend, his Faz, we donated.
Now Faz with his friends donated their old clothes.
Okay,
this is our correct answer.
Okay,
so for question number 19, our correct answer is Faz with his friends donated their old clothes. Now question number 20. cooks the broth many to spoil.
Okay. The broth cooks too many spoils.
No, doesn't make any sense.
The broth cooks spoil too many.
The cook broth spoil too many.
Now, this is our sentence. Too many cook spoils the broth.
Okay.
It means if there is too many cook for a single dish, the dish gets ruined. The dish gets ruined.
Okay.
So, it was an interesting chapter to read and to practice. Practice all these things in your own house. This kind of questions will be there in your Olympiad exam. And with that, we finish this chapter and this video. Okay, students, bye.